Engage, okay.
Engage. This is the Convectron gauge. This is the one I was talking about that's used for the interlock switching, for the vacuum interlock.
Mm-hmm.
This is the gauge that also will tell you the pressure when the chamber is vented. And the gauge at the bottom is the capacitance manometer. So this is your process gauge. This is what you'll be looking at during your processing.
Mm-hmm.
About some of these other things here. We have our main power distribution boxes. So there's a single phase 208 power feed going into the back of each of these boxes independently. Single phase 208 rated for 30 amps in each box.
Mm-hmm.
Also 30 amps. each has its own mains power switch to distribute power throughout each individual box. And each one has a breaker for the vacuum pump. So this one's for the main chamber.
Yep.
So you just turn this off, it'll turn off the vacuum pump immediately, the turbo will spin down.
Mm-hmm.
When you're ready to pump again, you just turn it on. And then we have one for the load lock. Same thing.
Mm-hmm.
And our RF power supply here with a matching network. We'll play with that in some detail later. It's the touch screen. Just has a protective cover over it right now. It's a little foggy. this is used for controlling the pneumatics. So we can set our gas flow here and open up the isolation valve.
Mm-hmm.
And down here, this controls all the shutters on the sputter guns. And then you have many extra buttons as well if you add anything to the system. It's the heater controller. You're controlling the lamps and that heater. It's got the power supply portion and then the PID control portion. You're stabilizing the temperature. We'll play with that as we go. Down here, we have the sample rotation controller. Rotation and the Z
mm-hmm.
as well. So this would be for rotation. You just turn it on and see on the right at the bottom.
Yeah, it's moving, yeah.
And then if we use this stick to go up and down, we can go up and down.
Yeah, it moves down. Mm-hmm.
There's no motion this way, though, on this particular one. Oh, actually, no, it is wired up. You can manually rotate. It's just not very... You can't really need it on this mm-hmm. particular system. This is
for the pumps?
Yep, controller for the main chamber, controller for the load lock, for the turbos.
Uh-huh.
Not much you need to do with them. They're kind of, you know, just do their own thing in the background. You're really just controlling it through that breaker switch. And sometimes I'll kind of look in here to see. Let's take a look at the drive current. This
mm-hmm.
current is very good for the main chamber. I'll use this kind of as a baseline indicator for the condition of the chamber. If there's a lot of outgassing in the chamber, that current might be a lot higher. Or if there was some kind of
yep.
leak in the chamber, so mm-hmm. it'll have a gas load on the top.